increase our faith, but help us in our unbelief. Lacking perhaps in our ways to come to Jesus, wherein faith and hope are made perfect. Lacking perhaps as well in coming to Jesus, wherein evil is overcome. And so we say, I confess, Almighty God,
to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have committed
sin
in my thoughts and in my words, and what I have done and what I failed to do.
Through my fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me, O Lord.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, O Son, humbled himself and took the form of a slave, to redeem the human race from being captive to sin, grant your servants help in confinement, that they may obtain the freedom you destined to all. For we are your sons and daughters, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, what more shall I say? I have not time to tell of Gideon, Barak, Samson, Jephthah, of David and Samuel, and the prophets, who by faith conquered kingdoms, did what was righteous, obtained the promises. They crossed the mouths of the lions, put out raging fires, escaped the devouring sword. Out of weakness they were made take comfort, all who hope in the Lord. How great is the goodness, O Lord, which you have in store for those who fear you, and which toward those who take refuge in you, you show in the sight of the children of men. Let your hearts take comfort, all who hope in the Lord. You hide them in the shelter of your presence from the plottings of men. You screen them within your abode from the strife of tongues. Let your hearts take comfort, all who hope in the Lord. Blessed be the Lord, whose wondrous mercy he has shown me in the fortified city. Let your hearts take comfort, all who hope in the Lord. Once I said in my anguish, I am cut off from your sight. Yet you heard the sound of my pleading when I cried out to you. Let your hearts take comfort, all who hope in the Lord. Love the Lord, all you his faithful ones. The Lord keeps those who are constant, but more than requite those who act proudly. Let your hearts take comfort, all who hope in the Lord.
What have you to do with me, Jesus, Son of the Most High God?
out and entered the swine. The herd had about 2,000 crossed down a steep path into the sea, where they were drowned. The swineherds ran away and reported the incident in the town and throughout the countryside. And people came out to see what had happened. As they approached Jesus, they caught sight of a man who had been possessed by a legion, sitting there on the roof and in his right mind. And they were seized with fear. Those who witnessed the incident explained to them what had happened to the possessed man and to the swine. And then they began to beg him to leave their district. As he was getting into the boats, the man who had been possessed pleaded to remain with him, but Jesus would not permit him, but told him instead, "Go home to your family and announce to them all that the Lord in his pity has done for you." Then the man went out and began to proclaim the disciples what Jesus had done for him, and all were amazed. The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. As I said earlier at the beginning of the Mass, in the light of today's first reading from the letter to the Hebrews, the end, the basic question sort of the Psalm. In enter Christ, faith and hope are made perfect. In the light of today's gospel, in and through Christ, evil is overcome. Starting with faith, how many times this has been repeated and repeated and repeated by Jesus in all his public life and ministry. And so we have that beautiful prayer in Mark, chapter 9, verse 24, that says, "Lord, increase my faith, help me in my unbelief." That can be one of our beautiful prayers. Even as you are driving or as you are busy or walking, you can just say, "Lord, I pray, Lord, increase my faith. Help me in my unbelief." Many times, not many times, in fact, all the time, our perspective, our way of looking at things, or viewpoint, is so narrow, or becomes so limited, for many reasons: lack of knowledge, prejudice, bias within, the stagnating in our growth, mind, soul, spirit, and so on. And so we see only this or that. And like Jesus, we are failing to grow and keep growing in what is called in wisdom and in grace, in knowledge and in holiness. Because perhaps we just stop or have decided, of course, there are unconsciously, I decided to stop growing. So we see this, and we see that, and we see that. And now whatever is causing it, we think that, oh, it is science that brings us the solution, the solution of problem. Oh, it is technology, or a great system of economy, or politics, or culture. That's not what today's first reading says about faith. That's why we ask, Lord, increase my faith, help me in my unbelief. Because what is today's first reading tells us about faith? Remember Jesus? If only you have a seed, even if it's just like a mustard seed, you know the rest of that statement. But anyway, in the light of today's first reading, who by faith, these are the people I mentioned earlier, did it what? Conquered kingdoms, did things righteous, obtained the promises, closed the mouths of the lions, put out raging fires, escaped the devouring sword, and out of their weakness they were made powerful, making strong in battle, and turned back foreign invaders. Who by faith? No one, John of Austria, leading the battle of Lepanto. Many times today we are just so influenced by, again, science and technology, economy, politics, culture, or what we are learning, or what we are reading, or what we are watching on our screens. That's not what today's first reading is referring us to. And so therefore, we ask again, Lord, increase my faith. Help me in my unbelief that I may see. Because for lack of faith, the rest of the apostles, except John, fled away from Father. So did John and Mary and the other Marys present during the crucifixion. And so therefore, with faith, we hope. We hope for what? To bring the gladness and the future to the pains of the present, because faith of good works is dead, not faith translated into good works, of course. In hope becomes what? Not folding our arms as we watch history passing by, not something passing. But as faith translated into good works, we bring the gladness and gain the gladness of the future into the pains of the present. Thus we have in the light of today's gospel. What do we have? The unclean spirit coming out of the man, imagine possessed by legion. Do you know how many would that be? Spirits? 5,000 in one person? I did not want to live. They were spirits, want to claim to stay in a particular territory. This we know, I'm sure, that our experience, we like to stay around. But because of the power of Jesus, we say, well, what is and lead us into the swine and that. And they were allowed. And so many of them, 2,000 of them went jumping right into the sea and middle of the ground. are obtained. No wonder why, again, at the heart of one and only one message of Jesus, the reign of God, what is it after that is being declared? The reign of God is at hand. Therefore, repent and believe. That's the demand, the command, the imperative statement. So we ask the Lord, increase our faith. In a world where again and again, Pope Benedict said some a little more than almost 11 years back, particularly in December 51, 2010, he said, if there is no more, faith is vanishing and God is disappearing. In people's lives, Emperor President, of course, but that was his main talk. There is simple government people right at the heart of the Vatican. 4 days before Christmas, faith is vanishing and God is disappearing. And so ultimately, what will this bring us? This faith and hope, this power, your power, my power, each one's power. I said it in my homily yesterday. You and I, it's not just this priest or that person or that guy who can cast out demons. Each one. Yes, yes. Therefore, there's a bit of something. No. That's not my cup of tea. What? Not my cup of tea. What happens therefore when we skip the faith? What do we have in the light, in the last light of today's gospel? Then the man went out and began to proclaim in the Decapolis what Jesus had done to him and all the world amazed. And this is the point. Healing, deliverance, and liberation of exorcism. Again, as I shared that here, I asked a group of people, you want to be healed? Yes. What's the point of healing? Well, healing? No. The point of healing is so that you and I what? With the gift of being more and more healed. It's not for the sake of healing. To praise and thank God and to bring about more blessings. Not just to yourself, but so that others can have light and have light in abundance. That's the point of healing. As I said here, what would your being able to walk be if you are not walking to God? You're just walking and walking and walking around. What good will your being able to speak or to talk? Maybe just even cursing or engaging in gossip. What good will your being able to see? We're just engaging in what? This material or that material, or maybe an addict or an app or a pornographic material? What good would you be able to hear, you and I? If I am not hearing the word of God and acting on God's word. See? The whole point of healing is ultimately to give praise and thank to God, so that God's blessings continue and God's wisdom will truly be loved. As we become more and more free as sons and daughters of the freedom of God. So we pray for his gift, Lord, increase my faith. Help me in my unbelief, so that by some grace for freedom, faith and hope, even through become perfect, so that in the light of this gospel, evil meets overcome. In a world of continuing evil, please rise. And we continue to pray for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, and for all bishops of the world, that is they will become more holy, they become truly a saint as they engage in the mission of your Son. For this we pray the Lord. And we pray too for priests and leaders and the lay people, the lay who are in particular engaging in whatever form ministry of the church. That first and foremost, each one becomes a disciple of Jesus, and then sent as an apostle. For this we pray to the Lord. For the healing and peace of our world, the healing and peace coming from the Lord, for this we pray to the Lord. For those who are never far of being captive, body, soul, spirit, and mind, in whatever way, those are captive, absolutely to be persecuted to the faith. Those who are in prison, as they continue their belief in God. Those who are suffering, consequent wars, and all forms of violence in the home, in society. We pray for God's kingdom, for this we pray to the Lord. And we pray for peace in the world, for an end to apostasy in the church, for the strength and the unity in the family, for this we pray to the Lord. And we pray for the faithful departed, for all our loved ones, for all our souls in purgatory, for our relatives and friends, for God's eternal mercy, for each one of them, for this we pray to the Lord. And we pray for Anita Lopez Rivera, for this intention we pray to the Lord. We raise the God of our intentions, and for this holy sacrifice to us. We include in our prayers those people who are asking for prayers, and those people whom we promise to pray for. And on other intentions that we would like to offer to the Lord. All these and all our prayers of the Father, we ask for Christ our Lord.
Blessed be the Lord, our God, the creation of the fruits we have received, and the bread we all believe to endure the work of humanity to become us the bread. blessed are you, Lord, by the law of creation, for to you goodness we have received good. The wine we offer you for the bread of mine and the work of your hands, it will become our spirit, my friend. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may become acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Let us save your sacrament of human redemption, which you offer, your Lord. Grant your servants may be released from captivity and rejoice in us in freedom of soul. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is for your right and just, our truth and our salvation always and every court to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, our mighty and eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cross of our downfall might become the means of our salvation for Christ our Lord. We hear the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts with prayer, and singing down your spirit from them, night that you fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was to be prayed and entered willingly in his passion, he took bread. And giving thanks to the world, it and gave it to the disciples, saying, Christ, all of you to eat up for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, with supper ended, he took the cup, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Thanks. All of you drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood. The blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
the mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we open more the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have been worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember your church spread forth the word and bring your good accordance at charity. We grant our Francis of Pope and my own our bishop and our clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters upon us weep in the hope of the resurrection and all those that died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your faith. Have mercy on us, all we pray. And with a blessed virgin Mary, Mother of God, with St. Joseph, our blessed spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who are pleased to walk the gates, we remember to be glorious to eternal life in the grace and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let us, Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our lives. That by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await our blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ, for the kingdom of God. Lord Jesus Christ, who said, the author of peace, I give you my peace, I give you. Look, not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are the Son of the Lamb. will praise God's name with song. I will glorify him with thanksgiving. For the Lord listens to the needy and does not spurn his own in their chains. Please be seated. Let us pray. Mindful that Christ paid for our deliverance, we implore your mercy, Lord, upon our brothers and sisters that they may be released from captivity and become servants of your justice. For Christ our Lord, the Lord be with you. And may your mighty God bless you all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, come down by you and remain in you forever. Go in the peace of Christ as we continue to grow in God's wisdom and in his peace.